2 years ago, I came in the morning and the anemones had released a bunch of egg and sperm into the cold water exhibit where they're kept. I had no idea they were going to spawn, but they were doing it that morning. And, you know, it's whatever you had for the day, you just kind of throw that out the window and you go right into larval rearing mode. So you just start to scoop up as many eggs as you can, hope they're fertilized, and hope that the techniques that you've used with corals works on anemones, and happily it does. It's been truly fascinating to have a mass spawning in an aquarium. Typically, I only ever get to go to the wild to see corals spawning when I work with corals in the Caribbean. For their 2 year birthday, I wanted to have them out on exhibit for the public to view. It's quite a big tank, 2,000 gallons for something the size of a quarter. You know, it's easy for it to get lost. So what I did was I built a little platform for the anemones, for a couple of the anemones to sit on, to make them more visible for the public and to sort of showcase, you know, here are anemones 2 years old, and come celebrate them with us while they're on exhibit. You know, when they're first born, they're only a few millimeters in diameter, about the size of a pinhead. And today, the biggest one is a little bigger than a silver dollar. The smaller ones are about between a dime and a quarter size. They can get somewhere between 1.5 to 3 feet in diameter, so they get very big. And well, with anemones in general, we just don't really know how long they can live. It's possible that they can live decades or even hundreds of years. They are predators, catching small zooplankton, so they help keep other animals in check. And then they, of course, are prey items for other things to eat. So they are, you know, they have a niche in the ecosystem, just like any other predator-prey interaction. They're very slow. Nothing happens fast at all. These anemones that we're working with here are only found along the west coast of the U.S. In Canada. Coastal ecosystems throughout the world are threatened and under siege from coastal development, and so that could deteriorate their habitat, which could then decrease population numbers. It's been very rewarding and satisfying to see them grow up. I hope they outlive me.